Good morning and Jai Hind students. I am Nutan Gupta, sending the video of the chapter Climate of Our Country. Now I am going to read the mind opener. Anand says, "Oh, what a hot day." His sister says, "Thank God, we are going to Shimla tomorrow. It is cold place." One person is talking about the weather and other one talking about the climate. Can you say who is talking about the which? And what do you think is the difference between weather and climate? Now we will going to start the discuss the mind opener. Actually, Anand is the name of a character. He says, "Oh, what a hot day." And his sister says, "Thank God, we are going to Shimla tomorrow. It is cold place." Then Anand is saying, talking about the weather, and his sister talking about the climate. Now you have to identify that who is talking, what is the difference between climate and weather. Now we will read the next topic, weather and climate. When you say it is cold today or it is a rainy today, you are talking about the weather. Weather refers how hot, cold, rainy, windy or cloudy it is particular place of at a particular time. But when you say it is cold in the Himadri or coastal plains are warm and humid, you are talking about the climate. Climate refers to the weather condition of a large area taken over a long period of time. Now I am going to explain this. When we say it is a cold today or it is a rainy day, what a weather today, it is hot today, then you are talking about the weather. Weather refers to how cold, rainy, windy or cloudy it is today. So we can say weather is a condition of any particular place at a particular time. But when you say that it is a cold in Himadri or Himalaya or coastal plains are warm and humid, then you are talking about the climate. Because climate is refers to weather condition of a place or large area which remain over a long period time. Now, climate of a place. The climate of a place mainly depends on the following. First is how far it is from the equator. The farther away the place is from the equator, is colder it to be expected to be. The northern part of India is cooler than the south India. So, actually, these are the affecting factors of the climate. First is how far away it is from the equator. So, as we know that equator is a place where sun rays directly from the sun, so it is hot throughout the year. Now, it is depend of a place that how farther away is place from the equator. As place will be far from the equator, it is colder expected to be. You know, the northern part of the India is cooler than south India because it is so farther from the equator. Now I am going to read the second part. How high it is. The higher a place, a colder it is. For example, the higher you go in a Himalaya, the cooler it is, it becomes. Now the second factor of the climate affecting is the same. It is depend to higher a place and the colder it is. For example, higher you go in Himalaya, the cooler it becomes. And the third factor, how far it is from the sea. The wind from the sea affect the climate of the place. The coastal plains are neither too hot nor too cold because of the breeze from the sea. So this is the third factor, how far it is from the sea. The wind from the sea affect the climate of a place. Means we have to check that from where winds coming from coming, because if the wind is coming from the Arabian Sea, its effect will be different, and of other place it will be different, because coastal plains are neither too very cold nor very becomes nor very hot because of the winds from the sea. And everyone's life, where it is human being, of animals, plant, depends on the climate. What they eat, what they wear, in which type of house they live, in all the things depend on the climate of a climatic condition of a place. Now we will discuss the topic season. Most places experience a few months of hot weather, a few months of rainy weather, and a few months of the cool or cold weather in a year. Each of these divisions of the year that have the particular weather pattern are called season. India has three main seasons during the year, summer rainy season and the winter, generally weather condition of a place during this season determines the climate of a place. Okay, now we are going to discuss season. As we know, the whole year is divided into in hot, winter, rainy, autumn. So all these patterns we called season. India has three main seasons during the year: summer, rainy and the winter. The generally weather condition of a place during this season determines the climate of a place. Now next heading is summer. The summer season starts in March or April and the continue till May or June. In South India, it starts becoming hot in March and stays hot till after May. In North India, summer starts in April, goes on the till to June to July. In summer, it is a hot and dry in almost all part of India except the mountain. The sun is very hot and the days are longer than night. Hot days, wind called Lu, blow the northern plains. Dust storm are also in the common reason. The coastal plains are not so hot in summer because the cool sea breeze. However, it is very humid. That is, amount of the water vapor in the air is high. Humid weather is uncomfortable and it makes us sweat a lot. Sweat takes a long time to dry. Okay, now I'm going to explain. This is the picture of summer. Lu. Summer season actually starts in March or April and continue till May or June. On the South India, it starts becoming hot in March. Hot in March and stays hot till after May. And the North India, it starts in April and remain till June and July. In summer, mostly parts of the India affected by the summer, except the mountains. And in summer days are to be longer and the night are short. Hot dry winds called Lu. But the coastal plains are not so hot in summer because of sea. However, it is very humid. What is humidity? Humidity is the water vapor in the air. Really humid weather is not bearable. It makes sweat all the times, even in rainy season. Also, and the sweat taking long time to dry. Now the next topic is rainy season. From June onwards, wind full of moisture from Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal start flowing to the land. They are called monsoon wind. They bring rain to India. This season is called monsoon. Yes, now rainy season. From June onwards, wind full of moisture from the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal start flowing to the land. They are called monsoon winds, which brings rain to India is called monsoon season. The rainy season in South India starts in June, but in North India it starts in the end of the July or beginning of the July. And it remains till September. Some parts of India such as western coast and the eastern coast, northeastern coast states get very heavy rain. Mausinram is the Khasi Hill in Meghalaya. In Meghalaya received the highest rainfall in India. Parts of the northern plains and the southern plateau receive heavy rainfall. The Thar Desert in Rajasthan and the run of Kutch receive very little rainfall. The Coromandel coast receives rain in November to December. Now winter. From October onwards, it starts becoming pleasant. The sun is not so hot. The days start becoming shorter and the night longer. This marks the beginning of the winter. It continue till February to March. January is the coldest month. Winter are very cold. In the Himalayas, many places have snowfall. The northern plains are cold. The cold decreases as we go south. The coastal plains are pleasant during winter. Now we will discuss winter season. Winter season from October onwards, it starts become pleasant because this time sun heat is not so more. Days start becoming shorter and night became the longer. This is the mark beginning of the winter. It continues till the February to March. January is the coldest month. Winter are cold in Himalaya. In many places there are so many snowfalls. That's why the people of the living there feel very cold. Now, did you know? The highest rainfall ever recorded in a day, 182.5 cm in the La Reunion Island in the Indian Ocean. The highest rainfall ever recorded in one year is 2,540 cm in the Cherrapunji, India. This is the picture of low cloud over Cherrapunji, one of the wettest place in India. Thank you.